Hello friends, I am Hardik Patel. Welcome to the Django Rest Framework tutorial. In this video, I am going to give you a brief introduction of RESTful APIs. Because in this web series, we are going to learn about Django Rest Framework, which is helping us to build the REST APIs on top of Django Framework. So before learning that, I would like to introduce you REST. Okay, so let's start with that REST. So REST is basically representative state transfer, which is defining some set of key constraints and properties based on HTTP protocol. Till now, we were using HTTP for getting documents from the server, maybe some kind of pages. So those are the things we were using. Now the same HTTP protocol we are going to use for RESTful APIs. So there are some properties and some constraints which we should follow. So by following that, we can achieve. There are many things, like these are the things which I will explain after explaining key constraints. So what are the constraints you need to follow? That is, first is that you don't need to follow, but this itself says that this is the API. So first thing is stateless. Stateless means you don't need to worry about state at the server side of the client. So client context is not required to be stored at the server side, because REST itself is built like this. Just whatever you need, like whatever you want, just pass all the data with the request, enough information request, right? So you need to pass all the information which is required to server, which is required for server to understand what I need to do with this data. Let's say, for example, if you want to log in, you just need to pass username and password, and also you need to say that this is the request, post request, that's it. And the server side, you have built the API, you just need to understand, yes, this is the username, this is the password, this is the URL, this is the method. So this all things are required to understand what needs to be done at the server side. And let's take an example of login itself. If login is successful, then it will pass back in a response, that is token. So that token needs to be stored at the client side. And then maybe next request, you can pass the same token to explain server, that is, I am logged in. So you server can understand, right? So that is the concept of REST APIs. Now server doesn't need to store anything at the server side, like this is the user is logged in right now, this is something like that. Okay, so that is now removed. Second thing, resourceful. Now everything is on resources. Like if you have three tables in our database, like user, poll, and then employee. So poll itself is a resource, employee is a resource, and if you want to do any CRUD operations, you have methods are available, like get, post, put, and then delete. So those are the basic methods of HTTP protocol. So those methods can be used to do some operations to make request unique, to make request different, right? So whenever you do some post request to poll, server can understand that this is for creation a new resource of poll. Is it user wants to create new poll, user wants to create new employee. So that is called resourceful. Another thing, third is client server architecture. So as I am just saying that client is sending request to server responding back to client. So that is called a client server architecture. So that is another constraint. Layered system. In layered system, that means you can have multiple layer. Like first is you are sending a request, it will pass the same request to server, and server again pass that request to database. So that is called layers. Layers can be different, like one is security layer. It is just checking that user is authenticated or logged in or not. If it is there, then pass the same request to next layer, and it can execute actual operation which user want to do. So that is layered system. Another thing system is, that is cacheability. Cacheability is means it can be intermediary server, intermediary layer, anything. It can just cache the response of any API, and that can be helpful to improve the performance, because next time the same request is fired by any client, it can be sent to the client itself without passing through the server. So that can be again one more benefit of cacheability. So because of this all constraints, there are many benefits of the RESTful APIs. You can see here, state is not required to store at server side. Performance can be improved. Reliability can be increased. It can help to grow as a application, as a company as well. Because let's say for example, you are adding more and more components, then you just need to implementing APIs. You don't need to worry about client. You don't even need to worry about UI, anything. So it can help to grow. Last thing is cross-platform applications. So let's say for example, you have built login logout API, and then there is one employee database. You just allow to add employee, delete, any crowd operations, right? So the same APIs I can use to build Android application, maybe Linux application, Mac application, anything. So that is called cross-platform applications. This is another benefit. So if you have seen the Django series, in which we have built one application that is employee management system, in which we haven't used any REST API, right? So now if I want to build Android application just similar to that, then what I can do? Right now I cannot do without any APIs. I need to rework, right? I need to again need to work on the Django project. I need to build same APIs which I am using, same logic, right? Logic will be the same, just you need to do some tweaks so it respond back with data, not the pages, not the HTMLs which we were doing until now before REST, right? So this is you can see here one example I have written here, that is, this is user is a resource. I have make one URL, I have made one URL that is just user, right? So if I use this URL and this is get method, if I am saying to server, then it will pass data of users, list of users in a response. So I can get those users, I can do anything I want to do. Even I want to list down them, I want to just list down names, anything. Next, if you pass the ID like this, this is users but one ID. So this is ID, it is saying that it is identify user resource which has ID 1, right? So now we know that this is the URL for resource user ID which is having ID 1. So now for that you can use all methods, get, delete and put, except post, because post is usually used for creating new resource, and whenever you are creating new resource you don't need ID because it is auto generated when you are actually generating, right? So for post this is enough. This is for getting single resource details, delete for deleting that resource, put is for updating the same resource, right? Now you all know the concepts of these methods, how we can use, right? So the same concept we need to apply for REST APIs. So I think you now understand what is REST, how we need to build, how will be the structure of the REST APIs. This is, you can say, another term that is endpoint. So this is the endpoint of user resource, like that. So this is the another term for RESTful API. Now why we are going to use Django REST framework? Because it helps us to build RESTful APIs very faster, in an efficient way, and without any more errors, because it is handling itself, because it has done many development, much more development to just handling those errors, raising exceptions, validations, right? So those we don't need to worry about. If the REST framework is not there, then we need to do our own self, right? Ourselves. So that is helpful. That will be again one more thing, that is, if we develop these APIs, that might be a performance problem, but they have also taken care of performance as well. So we are going to use Django Rest Framework. Again, there are so many competitors to Django Rest Frameworks, but why we are choosing this, that you can see here. In djangopackages.org, this is a website. This is one website which is provided by Django itself. It contains all kind of categories which you can see here. You can click on anyone to get the packages related to that category. So we are going to build API creation. So for that, I just clicked on that, and this is the page for that. Another is there, Django Rest Framework, specifically just for the Django Rest Framework, because this is, you can say, very bigger thing for Django itself, right? Because of this Django Rest Framework, Django's reputation is also making good. So these are the frameworks you can see here in the columns. Now you need to look at this all the parameters, and you can now decide which is the best for you. According to my opinion, Django Rest Framework is good because there are many applications are using, Python 3 support is there, and this is in a production stable version. Commits are completely active. Every day commits are coming. That means they are improving continuously. Documentation is available. There are many serializations protocol are available. OAuth OAuth2 is supported. Right? So this admin interface is also there. So you can see here there are many benefits over these other frameworks. That's why I'm choosing Django Rest Framework. Now in this video, I'm not going to take any much time because that's it for this video. And we will start with Django Rest Framework in the next video. We are going to install that, and we will maybe start with basic APIs so you can understand how it works. Okay, so that's it in this video. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel if you haven't, and please press the bell icon to get notification for upcoming videos. Thank you.